warm welcome to this Videometer webinar on the automation of oilseed rape quality inspection. We are very pleased to welcome such an international group of people all the way from Brazil, US, China, India, over Ukraine, to a number of European countries. Two of us here from Videometer will be conducting this webinar today, and we would just like to introduce ourselves. So, Karsten.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. I'm Karsten. I have been with Videometer since 2004. My educational background is within image processing, and I have worked the last 25 years with the analysis of granular products, including seed and grain, which is one of the main focus areas of Videometer.
And I'm Pia Van Der Zee. I've been working for a number of years with the business development and sales of instruments for quality control. And here at Videometer, I'm very much focused on seed and grain applications. We'll start with a presentation of around 25 minutes by the two of us, and it will then be followed by a Q&A session. So please write your questions in the chat during the presentation, and then we'll try to answer as many questions as possible. Please just add your name also, because in case we do not have time for all questions, then we'll get back to you. And I should just add also that the webinar will be recorded. So just a few words about Videometer. Videometer was founded in 1999 at the Danish Technical University. We have headquarters in Copenhagen, in Denmark. We have partners worldwide, and we are present in 40 countries. We have 690 imaging solutions worldwide, and that covers both standard solutions, one of which we will be presenting to you today, and customized visual inspections, typically on production lines. But let us jump right into the oilseed rape quality control. So to the upper left, you can see the traditional manual visual inspection that many of you can probably relate to. And then below is the automated Videometer solution that we would like to talk much more about. But why consider a Videometer spectral imaging for quality control? It offers a powerful characterization of seed and grain. The technology is automated and fast, it's reproducible, and the results are automatically documented. So specifically for oilseed rape, we offer fast and extended determination of oilseed rape admixture content. So there is a determination of the oilseed rape content versus non-oilseed rape content, or the admixture content. In the model, there is a breakdown of admixture content into inert material like stone, sticks, and foreign seeds, which could be cleavers, shallot. There is an analysis of 50 gram sample within 5 minutes with a variation of about 1%. And then there is a reporting and documentation, both visually and as Excel. So where can this technology be used? It can be used during inspection at seed producing the companies, and then it can be used for incoming quality control at trading companies or at oil producers. I would just like to show you the system, and I'll pass the word to Karsten.
Yes, thank you. The following video demonstrates our autofeeder system, which analyzes OSR samples automatically without any sample preparation. All you need to do is to place sample in a funnel, press start, and then you have the result 5 minutes after. 5 minutes is for a sample size of 50 grams. You can also run smaller or bigger samples through the system, as the funnel offers obviously a fairly flexible intake. The seeds, the sample is presented, transported on a belt, which is which is moved under the camera system. The camera acquires images, and the seeds are segmented into separate images. So we, in fact, obtain images for all the seeds and admixture parts in the sample. They're shown here to the left. You see here the user interface in the system, which shows both the images as they are scanned and also the result of the sample. So the result consists of statistics for the sample, as well as the images, and the images can be inspected afterwards, after the analysis, if the operator wants to do that. Moreover, an Excel format file is stored automatically to file. So this file shows a result for a sample, which contains 98.2% rapeseed material and 1.8% admixture. And the admixture is distributed on different fractions, including inert material, some grain, and also a little few cleavers for this particular example. This is just to show the results, an example of how the result looks. It's a small walkthrough of the different classes, which is analyzed with the system. We have the oilseed rape, of course, consisting of both husked and dehusked seeds, plus also bits and pieces of oilseed rape material, as we are measuring oil content material in this classifier. We are not inspecting the quality of the seeds as such. The mixture consists of inert material, grains, and a whole range of wheat seeds, including cleavers, charlock, wild turnip seeds, cranesbill, hedge mustard, bourgeois, fat hen, shepherd's purse, and poppy seeds. So seeds of many different sizes and shapes. The vision system in the autofeeder scans multispectral images. Normal camera images scans RGB images that contain information only from the visual range, which is between 400 and 750 nanometers. The multispectral imaging system also includes wavelengths in the ultraviolet range region, going down to around 300 nanometers, and in the near range, which goes up to around 1000 nanometers. And moreover, the multispectral system also contains more wavelengths within the visual range. This means that we are capable of characterizing the objects we're looking at in much detail, and this and we hereby obtain a system which is very powerful at separating and classifying the different seed types in the sample. Here is an example of how the multispectral image looks when coming out from the autofeeder. The multispectral image, in fact, consists of 19 images representing different wavelengths, starting in the top left, 375 nanometers, 405 nanometers, etc., up to 970 nanometers. The image you're looking at here consists of both oil rapeseeds and admixture types. And what we see is that the oilseed rape and the admixture respond differently in the different wavelengths. And this makes it possible to perform a very robust separation of the two seed types. I would like to show you an example of this, namely the separation of rapeseed and charlock seeds. Here to the right, we see six RGB images of charlock seeds in the top row. And then we have six RGB images of oilseed rape seeds in the bottom. And in the RGB image, we can see that they look very similar. They have a very similar color. However, the spectrum for the two, if we look at the full spectrum, there's actually a color difference. Over here to the left, you see the spectrum for the two seed types. The x-axis shows the wavelengths ranging from 375 nanometers up to around 1000 nanometers. And the y-axis shows the response in the different wavelengths. And we see indeed that there are differences in the color when looking at the UV, the ultraviolet range, and also in the near infrared range. This makes it possible to create, calculate some transformations that enhances the contrast between the charlax seeds and the oilseed grapes. And result of this, an example of this transformation is shown to the right, where we have again the top, we have the charlax seeds that show up as with a red color in this energy image, and the oilseed grape showing up with a blue color in the energy image. So, apart from the color information in the multispectral image, we make use of a whole range of the blob features for characterizing the seeds. We have features that characterize, measure both shape, contour, size, and texture, holes, all kinds of different characteristics that can occur on the seeds. In fact, we have more than 100 different blob features, of which we use around 50 blob features in the OSR model. And after having calculated 50 blob features for all the seeds, we apply machine learning methods to create a classifier that classifies the seeds into the classes in the OSR model. The machine learning method we're using is a random forest classifier, which I will not go into detail with here, but if you have questions later, at a later stage, we can of course give you some more information about this.
And now I'd just like to share a case with you from an oilseed rape trading company in the UK. They have their peak analysis time in July and August, and the farmers, they are paid according to the admixture content of above or below 2%. So before in the lab, a traditional manual visual inspection took place. And well, afterwards is of course the Videometer solution. So looking at sample analysis time, then before it took from anything from 5 minutes to 1 hour, depending on the admixture content, to analyze 10 gram of sample. Now 10 gram of sample is analyzed in 5 minutes. When looking at the results, then before a total admixture content was given. Now, besides that, an additional breakdown of the admixture content is given. Looking at the variation, there was a substantial difference, a substantial variation in between the manual inspections with the Videometer solution. Then there is an average of 1% of variation. With respect to training, there was a need for training of seasonal workers, yes, that came in typically new ones every year. And now there is limited need for training of new users because it's easy to use. Before, farmers were regularly disputing results, which meant that the samples, they need to be reanalyzed. Now the results, they are objectively reported and documented. And that is quite difficult to question. Just looking at a few data from the same oilseed rape trading company in the UK. Then over here, we see data from 8 oilseed rape samples. Inspected both manually and with the Videometer solution. So the blue bar shows a manual inspection by a seasonal worker. And then the orange bar shows the results from an expert technician who has worked in this area for many years. And then the last bar is the Videometer results. So when looking at the results, then with respect to sample 1, 2, 3, 7 and 8, well, the results are quite similar. However, they differ significantly in sample 4, 5 and 6. What can be seen here is that there is a significant variation between the two manual inspections. And at the same time, the Videometer results, they correlate very nicely with the results of the expert seed technician. With respect to implementation of this type of solution, what is provided? A standard European model is provided from our side, and there's a possibility for a yearly model maintenance agreement. Local adaptations of the model is possible, which might be needed in the case of additional local admixture types. After 2 times 2 hours of remote installation and training modules, you're basically up and running with the basic operations of the solution. After additional 2 times 2 hours of training and follow-up models, then you're basically able to use more advanced tools and features. So to conclude, then the Videometer spectral imaging is a mature technology. It's automated and fast. It's reproducible. It's transferable, meaning that results can be compared throughout your organization on different instruments. It can be operated by any technician, and there is no sample preparation needed. Then, just like to share a couple of more slides with you, because now we have been presenting the oilseed rape application, but Videometer offers a wide range of other applications. So with respect to seed and grain staying in this area, we do offer quality inspection of other grain types, for example, malting barley. We look at other parameters like seed health that you can see over here to the left. Here is a malting barley sample infected with red fusarium and grain mold. And over here to the far left is what you can visually see. And then just beside it is what can be detected by the Videometer technology. So a much clearer impression of the areas which have been infected. We can also look at vigor. Here's an example of germination and the length of the aqueous vials. Seed treatment, and what we see here, and is an example of seed coating that can be assessed. We also have quite a few applications for the analysis of granular products. We also have applications within food quality, safety, and authenticity. And we have a couple of examples here again. That is moisture in biscuits. This is what you see with the eye. And this is what is shown with the Videometer solution. Up here, you can see ground almonds that has been adulterated with peanuts. Very difficult to see here with the eye, but shows up much clearer with the Videometer technology. So right now, we would just like to open up for a Q&A session. And we will just be looking for help here from our colleague who has tried to collect your questions.
First of all, I would like to thank you for the presentation. We also gathered a lot of questions from our attendees, and we are still, of course, open for new questions that might come up. First question is from Sarah. Do you have models for other grain types than OCR?
Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Certainly, we have models, classification models that measure purity and seed health in various crops, including maize, barley, sunflower, and Within vegetable seeds, we have also numerous models within for crops, including spinach, carrot, tomato seeds, pepper, and many more. So, yes, we do.
Thank you. Next question from Erpin. Can Videometer identify variational differences within OCR along with identifying admixture with other than OCR?
If we can find other types.
If we can identify admixture within other things than OCR.
Yes, yes. The admixture model is also is also available with other crops, including sunflower and barley, wheat, and many other types of crops, you can say. It's the same, and in some situations, we can basically copy the collection of wheat seeds from one classifier to another. And in some cases, we cannot, because the wheat seeds will vary typically with the size of the main seed inspected.
Thank you. Next question is from Christina. Do the system need a calibration for other regions, stones difference, and other grains?
Yes, the model we have presented here is primarily developed for European customers so far, but it will be possible for you non-European customers to get a model which is tuned into your geographical region. Basically, what it will take is to tune the model in with the OSR varieties and wheat seeds which are relevant for your geographical region. So, but the model will be based on the same base model that you have seen today, say, and the functionality will of course be the same.
Thank you. Next question is from John. The technology is visually based. Do I get a weight-based result?
Yes, you actually do get a weight-based result. I think we have a slide somewhere.
Yeah, we can find a backup slide.
Yes, yes, here it is. Yeah, so the autofeeder system is a camera system, obviously, but we do present weight results anyway, and this is done during the modeling, the training of the model. It's done basically by presenting a small sample of each class in the model, taking it, first weighing it, and then taking the same sample and running it through the autofeeder, registering the total surface area of the sample, and combining that with the total weight of the sample provides a weight density for that particular class. And then when we have weight densities for all the classes in the model, it is possible to output weight percentages for the different classes as in the results.
Thank you. Ruud asks us, is there an option to physically separate different classes of seeds materials?
There will be very soon. It's coming up. It's not in the solution that we have presented today in the video. This is not possible, but we are working on a solution with a robot that pick out specific seeds according to your wishes. So it could be that there is a specific wheat type which is very rare, and where you would like to have a manual inspection of those seeds classified. And this will be possible with the robot system, as it will take out the seeds that have been classified into this wheat seed.
So imagine the robot kind of coming after the conveyor belt of the VideometerLab autofeeder, huh?
Yes, yes, exactly.
We're working on that.
Yes, so that will be available sometime soon.
Yeah, summertime.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so I think we are about up with the time right now, so we want to thank you for all the really good questions.